So what is this right here?
This is the Razer Switchblade. It's a technology concept. So with this concept, we wanted to show off the keys that we can pull off on this product, which is dynamic tactile keys. And what they do is they change appearance to according to whatever you're running on the PC here. So if you just want to run normal word processing, you have your full set of QWERTY keys. And if you're playing games, you have the game icons directly on the keys. So the way that works is that there's an LCD screen below the keys, and the keys are clear. So you have a tactile feel, but the keys can actually change what they look like. So it's not just a touch screen, but it's actually a changing key. And then the upper screen is a touch screen as well. So you don't necessarily need to use a mouse if you use the product, but you can. There's a USB plug there as well. There's a mini HDMI plug. And it's running Windows 7, so it's a regular laptop with the Razer UI on top of it. But you can always switch back to Windows 7 as well.
So this is it's just
a concept, yeah.
Okay.
It's probably, once it hits the stores, it'll look a bit different. The first time we actually placed these keys, this technology, on an actual product is for the Star Wars keyboard. So you'll have 10 of these adaptive tactile keys on the Star Wars keyboard, which we should talk about next.
Yeah, sure. That looks nice.
So, alright, this is what our main announcement this year at E3, which is four products that we designed together with BioWare and LucasArts for Star Wars The Old Republic, the MMO game. So the most exciting one is probably the keyboard, which has the 10 adaptive tactile keys on the top right hand corner. So you're probably going to have your skills of the game in these keys, and depending on what character you're playing or what skills you're using, these keys will change their appearance. But they'll still feel like normal keyboard keys. And below that is an LCD touch panel. It's a multi-touch trackpad, but it's also an LCD screen, so it can display animated content, or outside of the game it can even display your media player or your numpad functions. And other than that, it's a normal gaming keyboard, so you have your full programmability, extra macro keys on the left side, gaming mode in it, and then the lighting on the edge of the keyboard is multicolor, so 16 million colors available on these. And then we have the mouse. Based on our very successful Razer Naga Epic. So you have the 12 button upgrade on the side of your mouse, which you can use to find your macros and skills too. And in addition to what the Naga Epic offers, the back of the mouse, this faction emblem, can be changed to whatever faction you're playing in the game. So if you're a Sith or a Jedi, you'll have your faction there. So, so all four products actually allow you to display whatever faction you want. So the mouse mat is a metal mouse mat. It's flippable, so if you flip the mouse mat over, you have your Republic icon. Right now it's the Empire. And the headset is 5.1 surround sound with the USB connection. Flexible microphone boom and lightweight design, and of course you can change the faction panel as well. It has some lighting that shines down on your shoulders, so you can actually see some game alerts that we're going to come up with together with BioWare. So for example, if you're a Jedi and then a Sith is approaching, this headset will give you some kind of alert that you can see from your peripheral vision.
So we saw the announcement for this, so when is it going to hit the streets?
It's going to hit the streets as soon as the Star Wars The Old Republic game comes out. Maybe a bit before then, hopefully in November.
Yeah, we thank you for the tour. This is great looking stuff.